What's up guys, SuperEugene41 here, bringing you a Minecraft video showing off one of my most recent creations. This is a full-scale football pitch and stadium. It's called Stadio El Eugenio. Don't ask why, I was just bored and couldn't think of a name for it. As you can see, it's pretty lifelike with the four stands, the press boxes, the lights around the top, and the way the football pitch is set out. I was pretty pleased with it. The nets look pretty realistic. I'm obviously playing on creative mode at the moment, that's why I'm flying around. So I'm going to take you to the main entrance. If you were playing on survival, you would have to enter the stadium via this way. To the left here you have a VIP section. This stadium's about 90% complete, probably because I haven't filled out the rooms and stuff. As you can see, it's really bare. I'm going to put some TVs and stuff in here soon. Nice view of the football pitch from here. Pretty realistic, because if you've ever been to a football game, they have the sort of press boxes in the corner like that, and you can sort of lock in sometimes. Just going to take you to the main ticket office, if I can get out of this door. Right, down to the ticket office we go. Pretty nice touch this, I think, because you've got the employee section here, where they sell the tickets, and then obviously the fans would come in here and buy the tickets from these gates. And when you've bought your ticket, you advance to the paths to your stands. Stand A and C left, and stand B and D to the right. Now, stands B and D took a while to create, and that's because I haven't just simply made pathways on each side like you normally would to save time. What I've done is I've actually made the entrance to all four stands from one single entrance point, which is here, to save the hassle. In doing so, it took me about 2 hours just to try and link up the paths on the bottom and stuff. You'll see why in a minute, because it's a really confusing build and it's a really difficult seed to work with. But anyway, I'm going to take you to the away stand first. It says welcome to hell, because obviously the away fans want to be intimidated when you come into the stadium. As you can see, the hell effect with the fire and stuff, and you just come out on the other side, and it's pretty well done, I think. It looks pretty professional, with the little rail here in front of you, and the way it's all set out. And obviously you just take a seat. So yeah, that's the away stand, and because I'm using creative mode, I can just fly about, so no point to walk if you don't have to. Yeah, that was stand C. Stand A would be the main stand for the home support, which is this one, with the press box over there. I'll take you to that in a sec. In fact, I'll take you there now. That's just through here, as you can see here, VIP seating in the press. It's about 90% complete. I haven't put anything in this room yet. There's going to be some offices and chairs and stuff in here. But this is where stuff like your cameras would be, and the press and the pundits and all that. So yeah, pretty decent sized room and stuff. And it's the same old way on all four corners of the stadium. As you can see, it needs touching up a bit as well. It looks quite unprofessional at the moment, quite messy, like all the walls and that. It's soon to look like this, like all well decorated and stuff, because at the moment I haven't paid much attention to the decoration. Right, let's go downstairs and to our network of pathways. This is to B and D. Stand D is this way. We'll just quickly run to stand D. As you can imagine, this was really difficult to try and link up to where the stadium exit was, so I think I did a good job. Yeah, it takes you right out behind the goal, straight into the action, and yeah, you take your seat. We're going to fly over to stand, I believe, B, which is the other one you get to from that side. As you can see, same sort of feel for it. You come in behind the stand. Obviously, you can tell that I'm using the actual infrastructure of the stadium to my advantage here by joining it all together around the back, and here we are at stand B point again. So I haven't seen many people do this. I think it's very clever. Most people just tend to sort of I'll show you what I mean. Like, what I could have done to save a lot of time was make like a pathway around all of the all four sides, and sort of just led up to the, as you can see, there's writing as well. That's my girlfriend, Tasha. Yeah, because she helps me do this well. Yeah, I could have just put like a pathway here, and then stairs going in, and then entrance to the seating area. But I thought that would have looked a bit unprofessional. So I prefer this sort of stadium where it's all enclosed and stuff. It hasn't got lots of open spaces. Yeah. So also one finishing touch is just say you're a player, and just say you were a player or a fan who decides to run onto the pitch. The players will come into this after half time, and the dressing rooms are there, home team dressing room and away team dressing room, pretty identical rooms really, nothing too special about that. But if you're a naughty fan and you get sent, you get arrested on the pitch, there's your holding cells in here. I thought that was a pretty good touch. So, you know, hooligans and stuff that run out onto the pitch, and like streakers and stuff, they get arrested and brought into this place. It's quite scary. Yeah, I mean, as you can see here from on the ground, it looks really realistic, to be honest. So I'm quite pleased with this build. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put like a little montage of pictures right from the first sort of foundation, which was just putting down the glass field. I'm going to put the progression all the way up to now, so you can see what I did, how I made the stands and stuff. Overall build time, I would say roughly 24 hours, like straight. Like I'd say 24 hours it takes to build a stadium of this magnitude. Just gonna give you a flyover look now before we go. As you can see, it's very symmetrical, very well made. Very pleased with this build. And if you wanna have, if you wanna compare your stadium to mine, if you feel the need to send me a message and I'll try and, you know, help you out if I have time. I must stress, time's limited, but if I have time, I will get on Minecraft and help you build your stadium. I hope I've gave some people the idea to build their own stadiums. I'd love to see what your stadiums look like. So anyway, I've been Super Eugene. This has been my stadium. I hope you've enjoyed it, and I am out. Peace. We built this city.